The assessment method within the PG Cap actually followed an ePortfolio, where you're in effect you're developing your own blog of your reflections as you go through the module. Now, this was something completely different to what I've ever done before, and to some extent, I think, shared with the rest of the cohort, I didn't really know what to expect or how to address it, how to somewhat be strategic with it. I didn't have any plans of how I was going to pass based on this ePortfolio, which often you develop strategies for your essays and your various other assignments, where the novelty of this sort of left me somewhat bewildered as to how to approach it. So what, in essence, you have to do is you do 6 500-word minimum assignments based on different observations that you've had, your game, and in-depth reflection throughout the module. But what the ePortfolio actually offered as well was that you had to do reflections on sessions within the PG Cap, and also your development away from the PG Cap. So you were always working on it, even if it was only 200 words, maybe 500 words a week, which doesn't sound a lot, especially when you write a PhD, but it just kept your mind active, you're always thinking about it. So that really helped. And I think with the good thing about the ePortfolio is the fact that it's electronic, is the fact that you can upload various types of multimedia. So maybe if writing isn't the strongest point, you can upload videos, you can upload audio files, and these videos and audio files will go hand in hand with the reflections that you're writing as well, to really capture that, not just your viewpoint on paper, but also people observing can try and give you that third perspective as well. And also, one of the best things about the ePortfolio is the fact that other people on your cohort can contribute, tell you where you're going well, where they think you can improve. So it's just an all-round perspective of everyone in the cohort, and the module reader, and anyone else who's interested in reading it, really.